بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Greet you all with the greeting of Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace and the blessing of Almighty Allah be with you all. I'd like to welcome you all for continuation of our series, Reading and Translating from the Book At-Targhib wa At-Tarhib by Imam Al-Munziri rahmatullah alayh. This morning we're making segment number 42, Kitab al-Salah, the Book of Prayer. At-Targhib fi al-Adhan wa ma jaa fi fadlihi. Encouragement towards the calling the adhan and the reward of it. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لو يعلم الناس ما في النداء والصف الأول ثم لم يجدوا إلا أن يستهموا عليه لاستهموا ولو يعلمون ما في التهجير لاستبقوا إليه ولو يعلمون ما في العتمة والصبح لأتوهما ولو حبوا. Narrated Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, that the Prophet of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم is saying, if the people know the reward of being in the first rank of Salah, and the reward they will receive for calling the Adhan, and they have no means to achieve it unless they cast lots, they will do so. And if the people know the reward of going to the early prayer, Fajr, they will compete with each other to do so. If they know the reward of making Isha in the mosque as well the morning prayer, and they have no means to do it other than to crawl on hands and knees, they will do so. This is a serious hadith, is it? Mm-hmm. Subhanallah. See how nowadays Allah give us all these facilities, cars, bikes, everything. And now when you go to the masajid, this masajid almost empty from people making Fajr or making Isha. But if this is the time for their shift at their work, they'll be up and they will go. They will go to the bus station and they wait for the bus. So the Prophet ﷺ telling us, if we know, if we come to realization how much reward you will get by making Isha in Jama'ah, the mosque, making Fajr, and you have no means to do it other than crawling in your knee, your hands and your knees, you will do so. Subhanallah. The second hadith by Abdullah ibn Abdul Rahman ibn Sa'sa'a, ibn Abi Sa'id al-Khudri radiallahu anhu, qal lahu, inni araka tuhibbu al-ghanama wa-badiyah, فإذا كنت في غنمك أو باديتك فأذنت للصلاة فارفع صوتك بالنداء فإنه لا يسمع مدى صوت المؤذن جن ولا إنس ولا شيء إلا شهد له يوم القيامة. that Abdullah ibn Abd al-Rahman ibn Sa'sa'a, that Abu Sa'id al-Khudri said to him, I see you love taking care of sheep and be in the desert. So whenever you are a distant and you are among your sheep and your goats, the field, so proclaim the adhan and raise your voice with the adhan, because none hear the voice of the muezzin, a human or jinn or any living thing, unless will be witness for him in the day of judgment. Abu Sa'id is saying, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying, that when you're too far from the city, with taking care of your sheep, and there's no way to come to the mosque, you by yourself there, far away, call the adhan. And when you call the adhan, raise your voice with the adhan. Because anything will hear your voice. A tree, a rock, a human being or jinn will become witnesses for you in the day of judgment, that they heard your voice, that they heard you calling the adhan. In another narration, he's saying, يغفر للمؤذن منتهى أذانه ويستغفر له كل رطب ويابس سمعه. It be forgiven the muezzin, will be forgiven for his sins as far as the voice of his call for the prayer reach. No rock, no tree, no jinn or mankind, unless he will come witness for him that he heard his adhan. Subhanallah. In another narration, he said, وَلَهُ مِثْلُ أَجْرِ مَنْ صَلَّى مَعَهُ, that he will be also getting the reward. The muezzin will get the reward of anybody who joins the rank in the salah. Because when the people hear the adhan, they will come for salah. So he's the one who called for the prayer. So everyone came to pray, he will get also an equal reward for those people. Now we can see why adhan is so rewarded, that people have to cast lots. If they have no choice to get it, other than competing and making cast lots, they will do it. Subhanallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open our eyes and our hearts to see the blessings of calling the adhan, be concerned about it, and that we be there where the adhan is called, or that when we know the time for adhan, that we answer the call of the muezzin, inshallah. Jazakumullah khairan. May Allah bless your day. Subhanakallahu wa bihamdik. أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك. الله knows best. وإياكم.